It was a relief to finally feel the sun on my face and a gentle breeze in my hair. After all these caves, just breathing fresh air again was enough to clear my mind of any doubts I might have had about this strange journey so far. Along my journey, I had seen many pieces of floating rock, but here, they were much bigger. Some were big enough to fit whole villages. How was this possible? Maybe it had to do with the crystals that seemed to be everywhere. If the legends were true, the stray civilization was younger than the village. Yet, they were making great progress. They invented crystal-powered machines, produced their own fabrics, and built houses out of bricks and stone. It was like a civilization was forming before my eyes.
How come they didn't use crystals in the village like that? Didn't they have any?
They did have a few, but never used them. The villagers thought the crystals were sacred, that they were the source of life, and shouldn't be fiddled with.
Wait, didn't Fred use them?
For his power cores, yes. I guess he was an exception. The strays, on the other hand, they mined crystals and used them for all sorts of machinery and decorations. They praised them too, just in another way.
Play a game. I bet that you can't get through this part without using the grapple device.
Thank you. Mm-hmm.